الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين كذبت ثمود وعاد بالقارعة فأما ثمود فأهلكوا بالطاغية وأما عاد فأهلكوا بريح صرصر عاتية سخرها عليهم سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسوما فترى القوم فيها صرعا كأنهم أعجاز نخل خاوية فهل ترى لهم من باقية وجاء فرعون ومن قبله والمؤتفكات بالخاطئة فعصوا رسول ربهم فأخذهم أخذة رابية إنا لما طغى الماء حملناكم في الجارية لنجعلها لكم تذكرة وتعيها أذن واعية فإذا نفخ في الصور نفخة واحدة وحملت الأرض والجبال فدكتا دكة واحدة فيومئذ وقعت الواقعة وانشقت السماء فهي يومئذ واهية والملك على أرجائها والملك على أرجائها ويحمل عرش ربك فوقهم يومئذ ثمانية يومئذ فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فيقول هاؤم اقرءوا كتابيه إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابيه فهو في عيشة راضية في جنة عالية أَسْلَفْتُمْ فِي الْأَيَّامِ الْخَالِيَةِ وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِهِ فَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُوتَ كِتَابِيَهْ وَلَمْ أَدْرِ مَا حِسَابِيَهْ يَا لَيْتَهَا كَانَتِ الْقَاضِيَةَ مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَهْ هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيَهْ خُذُوهُ فَغُلُّوهُ ثُمَّ الْجَحِيمَ صَلُّوهُ ثُمَّ فِي سِلْسِلَةٍ ذَرْعُهَا 70 ذِرَاعًا فَاسْلُكُوهُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمِ وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَى طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ فَلَيْسَ لَهُ اليوم هاهنا حميم ولا طعام إلا من غسلين لا يأكله إلا الخاطئون فلا أقسم بما تبصرون وما لا تبصرون قول رسول كريم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا آمين. فلا أقسم بما تبصرون وما لا تبصرون إنه لقول رسول وما هو بقول شاعر قليلا ما تؤمنون ولا بقول كاهن قليلا ما تذكرون تنزيل من رب العالمين ولو تقول علينا بعض الأمر الأقاويل لأخذنا منه باليمين ثم لقطعنا منه الوتين فما منكم من أحد عنه حاجزين وإنه لتذكرة للمتقين وإنا لنعلم أن منكم مكذبين وإنه لحسرة على الكافرين وإنه لحق اليقين فسبح باسم ربك العظيم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه وولاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أصبحنا وأصبح المؤمن لله الحمد لله. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. أصبحنا على فطرة الإسلام وكلمة الإخلاص وعلى دين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى ملة أبينا إبراهيم حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين. Ask Allah to bless our day, to bless our gathering, to open our hearts with amn and iman and safety and taqwa, yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma ameen. The example of today, the method of today of the Quran, we recited yesterday in the Salah. We recited a few examples yesterday. The example of the Jannah that receives a Jannah which is in a highly or an elevated place that receives some water or more water, so it gives more harvest. If it receives less water, it gives still. And this is the example of the believer. When the charity is their characteristic. So charity is not based on how much you have. Charity is a sifa, is a characteristic, is an attribute. Like generosity a person is generous. When money comes, the generosity displays. Generosity manifests. But you are generous, regardless. So whatever you have, you become generous with. So if it is more or if it is less. Right? So that was the example. And the example of today, Allah Azza wa Jal is giving indirectly. There is an example that is given directly. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفَقُونَ أَمْوَلَهُمْ يَسَبِ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ حَبٍ. Example of this is like that. Then you can find the relation, right? So it's a direct example, but still you find the relation. Here, Allah Azza wa Jal is not saying, example of this is like that. No, he is giving you a straightforward scenario. And then from that scenario, you kind of understand why this is here. Why Allah is mentioning that. So it's not only you relate, but Allah wants you to answer why. What does that mean? Wants you to answer that. So Allah Azza wa Jalla says, أَيَوَدُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن تَكُونَ لَهُ جَنَّةٌ مِن نَخِيلٍ وَأَعْنَابٍ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ لَهُ فِيهَا مِن كُلِّ الثَّمَرَةٍ. That's half of the scenario here. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, would one of you like or desire to own a garden that has date palm trees of different types and species, and grapes of different colors and tastes and species? A'nab means different types of grapes, you can imagine. Dates, mashallah, you go in the market after Umrah or Hajj, you find like 100 types of dates, literally 100 types. It's not like an exaggeration, literally there's 100 types of dates. This date and that date and this and that, everything. So, نخيل وأعناب, your garden. Not only that, له فيها من كل الثمرات. يا سلام. Allahu Akbar. Has also all types of fruits. So you can imagine the grapes and the palm trees surrounding it. And then you have this section of banana and this section of pineapple and this section of this and this section of that. له فيها من كل الثمرات. Cool so far? Good? Beautiful? أود أحدكم? Yes or no? Of course, أود أحدكم أن تكون له جنة من نخيل وأعناب تجري من تحتها الأنهار, beneath which rivers flow. Not one river, like rivers. How big is that جنة? If there is rivers, right? So how did the أعناب and this garden means, mashallah, now we can imagine, right? It's not 5 acres in North Texas, it is more than that, right? طيب, until here is so good, but then comes the issue. وأصابه الكبر. Then became old. Not only that, وله ذرية ضعفاء. And his children or his offspring, they're weak. If you think this is worse, now listen to what's coming. فأصابها إعصار فيه نار فاحترقت. After all of this, a tornado with lightning in it. That lit the whole thing, that devours it. It burned it and it devoured it, burned it to the ground. فَأَصَابَهَا إِعْصَارٌ فِيهِ نَارٌ فَاحْتَرَقَتْ. It's burned to the ground. كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَفَكَّرُونَ. That's how Allah Azza wa Jalla is showing you the signs, so you might think, so what is the sign here? You see that? The same question was asked by Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu to the Sahaba. He said, ماذا تقولون في هذه? What you say about this? قالوا الله أعلم. الله رسوله أعلم. الله أعلم. قال إما تعلمون وإما لا تعلمون. Don't tell me الله أعلم like this only. I know الله أعلم. But I'm asking you, do you know or you don't know? So he knows, but he wants to trigger. So Abdullah ibn Abbas, he told him, I know the meaning. I have something from in my nafs for this. He said, don't, and he was a young man. He said, my nephew, لا تحقرن نفسك. قل, say, don't belittle yourself. Even you are among the adults. If you have knowledge, say it. This is a message for our youth. When you seek the knowledge, the age difference is not there. Respect is there. But when you have knowledge, you teach. Right? When you have knowledge, you teach. You become credible. But you have to seek it the right way, and you have to spread it the right way with respect and with love and sincerity to Allah Azza wa Jalla. So he told him, This is an example of amal, of the amal. Someone does good deeds and then come with bad intention and destroy it when he needs it the most. Now understand now what it means? So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, one of you would like to have this garden. MashaAllah, you are young, you are youthful, you are resourceful, you are healthy, and you are spending, and you are doing good, sincere. You are doing great job, you are doing wonderful. But then the shaitan accesses you. Then your ego comes, then your vanity comes. Then you say, me, I am the one who did, why this and that. It is like, now you are older, now you are not healthy, now you are this. Instead of this should be your savings, what happens? It is like ذُرِّيَّةٌ دُعَفَاءٌ. You are old, you are not able to do this. Now, again, you are not doing all the deeds. ذُرِّيَّةٌ دُعَفَاءٌ, يعني the offspring, the children should carry this farming, should carry, take care of that garden after you, right? But they are weak. Now also your a'mal is weak. Cannot carry you to Jannah. Cannot carry you to the pleasure of Allah. Used to, but now you stopped that and you destroyed it and you don't have enough a'mal to carry you. And then, فَأَصَابَهَا إِعْصَارٌ فِيهِ نَارٌ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. All these deeds will go and be blown in the wind. وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. And we came to all the deeds that they did and we made it like blown dust in the wind. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen. Those are kafirin, al-zalimin, wal-azbillah. But this is just to get it similar. So Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying here, فَأَصَابَهَا إِعْصَارٌ فِيهِ نَارٌ. So all these deeds will be blown away. Do you like that? See, you like the first part. Would you like the second part to happen? Yes or no?
No.
Exactly. So that is the answer that Allah Azza wa Jalla wants from us. You want the first half? Yes or no?
Yes.
You have to maintain it so you don't get the second half. You want the first half? Yes. I want the garden. You want the amal that takes you to Jannah? Yes or no?
Yes.
You have to maintain it. You have to maintain it till the end. You have to be truthful. You have to seek the knowledge. You have to keep coming to the masjid. You have to do the halqa. After Ramadan you continue. Don't build your garden in Ramadan and then destroy it after. Huh? Don't come into the salah and destroy it after. You finish the Quran once in Ramadan, then you desert it for the rest of the year. فَأَصَابَهَا إِعْصَارٌ فِيهِ نَارٌ فَاحْتَرَقَتْ. So what are you doing just for Ramadan or for the sake of Allah? I hope the example is very clear for us. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who build this garden of hasanat, build this garden of a'mal al-salihat, and maintain it until we meet him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he rewards us with the real gardens of eternity. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. May Allah bless your day. Allah give you the barakah of this day. صلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.